turn me into a serial killer. I know they did, because I was no professional serial killer or anything, or murderer or whatever you want to call it, you know. I wasn't special at what I was doing.
Aileen,
I did some sloppy work, you know, and I left.
How have you?
I'm leaving. I'm glad. Thanks a lot, society, for railroading my ass. Okay, let's go.
Aileen Wuornos was born Aileen Carol Pittman on February 29th, 1956, in Rochester, Michigan. She then was executed October 9th, 2002, in Florida State Penitentiary. Before covering any of Wuornos' crimes, I'm going to do a quick rundown on her rather screwed-up childhood. She was actually born without ever meeting her father, because during her birth, he was actually incarcerated for sex crimes against children, where he later ended up hanging himself in prison. When Aileen was just 4 years old, her mother ended up abandoning her and her siblings, and she ended up being adopted and raised by her grandparents. When she was around 11 and 12 years old, she started doing sex acts for favors such as cigarettes, money, and she would also do it just so she can get food. At the age of 14, Wuornos became pregnant. It's rumored that she was raped by a friend of her grandfather's. She ended up moving into a home for unwed mothers where she gave birth to her son, which she ended up giving up for adoption. Now at the age of 15, her grandfather had thrown her out of the house and she was living in the woods around the neighborhood. The very harsh and cold winters of Michigan became too much for Aileen. This is what led her to hitchhike to Florida. Aileen has quite the list of crimes, and I'm not going to cover every one of them. So with that being said, let's get on to the killing.
Before I can get too in-depth with the murders, you need to understand Tyria Moore. Aileen had met her in the spring of 1986, and they had later moved into a hotel together. She would support the two by prostituting, and this is what ultimately led to her murdering her victims.
Wuornos' first murder took place on November 30th, 1989. The victim was 51-year-old Richard Mallory. He was an electronics store owner from Clearwater, Florida. When police found his body, he had been shot several times with a small caliber pistol. During the autopsy, they had seen that two of the bullets had struck his lungs and believed this is what led to his death. Wuornos' next victim would be David Spears, 43 years old. He was a construction worker from Winter Garden, Florida. On June 1st, 1990, his body was found along Highway 19 in Citrus County, Florida. Again, he had been shot multiple times with a small caliber pistol. Wuornos' next victim would be Charles Carskadon, a 40-year-old part-time rodeo worker. His body was found on June 6, 1990 in Pasco County, Florida. He had been shot 9 times with a small caliber pistol. After Carskadon's body was found, this is when police knew they had found a serial killer. The first 3 victims were all shot with a small caliber pistol. They were all murdered in the same style. And at each crime scene, there was evidence proving that there was prostitution involved. This is also what led them to believe that they had come across a woman serial killer. Investigators would finally get their big break on July 4th, 1990. They were called out to a scene in Orange County, Florida, where a car had been wrecked and abandoned. Inside the vehicle, they find a bloody handprint, which they would later link to Wuornos. Also, after running the plates, they had found that the car belonged to a man that went missing. The man was Peter Symes, age 65. He was a retired merchant seaman and a devoted Christian outreach minister. He had been last seen leaving his home in Jupiter, Florida in June, and his body was never found. Of course, they linked the murder to Wuornos. 50-year-old Troy Burris would be Wuornos' next victim. His family had reported him missing on July 31st, 1990. Police later found his body on August 4th in a wooded area along State Road 19, right outside Marion County, Florida. He had been shot twice with a small caliber pistol. Wuornos' next victim would be Charles Humphreys, a 56-year-old retired Air Force major and also former police chief. He'd been shot multiple times, including shots to the head. His body was found September 12, 1990 in Marion County, Florida. He was fully clothed, and also his car would be later found in Sewanee County, Florida. Wuornos' final victim would be Walter Antonio. He was a 62-year-old police reservist. His body had been found completely naked in a remote logging road in Dixie County, Florida. He was shot four times. The police found his car 5 days later in Brevard County, Florida. After Antonio's murder, Wuornos became very paranoid that the police were catching up to her. This is when Tyria Moore had fled back to Pennsylvania and later on would be caught by police. They would get her to agree to a plea agreement if she would testify against Wuornos in a trial. And after they got her to agree, they would move in and arrest Wuornos. When Wuornos was first arrested, she had claimed that all the murders were in self-defense and that she was a prostitute, and when the men would attack her, she would kill them. She also would go on to say that Tyria had no clue at what she was doing, and that she had only admitted to shooting Richard Mallory. Wuornos' trial would go on to be a media frenzy. She was known to say some off-the-wall stuff during the trial, but she would keep to her story that she was an innocent woman and they were trying to condemn the raped victim. This next clip I'm gonna play shows you how crazy Wuornos was and where she all of a sudden just changed her whole entire story and wanted to die.
Okay, I cannot go in the execution chamber and die in the execution chamber as a liar. And I cannot go in the execution chamber and be executed under the devil. I have to come clean and cleanse my spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. So I have to come clean and tell the world the lies that went on through my mouth. I mean, now prosecutors and
well,
cops.
And that you killed seven men.
Huh?
That you killed those men in cold blood.
Yeah, and I got to come clean that I killed those seven men in first-degree murder and robbery.
Aileen Wuornos would go on to be executed on October 9th, 2002 in Florida State Prison by lethal injection. She will go down as one of the most infamous women serial killer of all time. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Sorry this was a little choppy. Again, I'm working with some new software and I'm working out the bugs. I also want to make a suggestion. It's on Netflix right now. Nick Broomfield did an awesome, awesome biography on Aileen Wuornos. It's by far one of the best ones you can find, and I highly recommend you check it out. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys later.